To God be the glory, in Jesus' mighty name. You all are absolutely amazing, wonderful, glorious, and absolutely beautiful. I really want to thank each and every one of you, to those who are commenting, to those who are subscribing, and also to those who are sharing. May the Lord continue to honor each and every one of you individually and to bless you. Thank you so much for just being able to share this bread and this wine and just being able to release it unto creation. In Jesus' name, amen. So today, I just wanted to bring this word onto somebody out there. And while I was just sitting with the Lord, all I kept perceiving in the spirit, I kept hearing just that word, they want to meet with you. They want to meet with you. It's like somebody wants to meet with you. And Holy Ghost basically just put it in this sentence. They want a meeting with you. That's basically the sentence that was given. They want a meeting with you. And I was just wondering, Lord, help me to understand this even much more clearly. And to God be the glory. Indeed, I was taken to the book of John chapter 12, and in verse 20, it talks about, it says here, now there were some Greeks among those who went up to worship at the festival. They came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee, with a request. Sir, they said, we would like to see Jesus. Now you have to understand, this was the dimension of when Jesus came into Jerusalem. Yeah, he was anointed, and then he went into Jerusalem. He was riding on a colt, and a donkey, the colt of a donkey, and then he was riding all the way through, and they were throwing palm branches at him. Hosanna, blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord, blessed is the King of Israel. And Jesus found a donkey, the Bible says, and sat on it. And can you see? It says, do not be afraid, daughter Zion. See, your king is coming seated on a donkey's colt. So you can see, as Jesus was doing all of these things, people were basically all around him watching what was going on. So right in the midst of it, some people came and said, hey, we want to see that man who literally was just doing all of these things, riding on a donkey and all of those things. And they requested for a meeting. So for some of you, whether it's at your place of work, whether it's even in the environment that you are, you've been doing what God has called you to do. You've been doing it faithfully. You've been doing it lovingly. You've been doing it with absolute joy at the same time, and everything that has come against you still continue to endure through it. And you have been, like the Bible declares, it says that the farmer went about sowing seeds, and some, the seed fell on good soil and it came forth with a harvest. And there is another dimension of a king who went away. He gave his servants 5 talents, 2 talents, and 1 talent, and the king came back and he said, what did you do with the 5? He said, I went and made 5 more. What did you do with the 2? And he went and made 2 more. So this is the dimension where many of you have been faithfully, working in the field that the Father has placed you. And the amazing part of it is, while you were doing what you were doing, someone has been watching behind the scene. Whether it's at your place of work, somebody had been taking notice of that in which you have been doing. Perhaps they didn't say anything. They will probably come into your place of work, say good morning, afternoon, oh, well done, have a wonderful evening. But you did not understand. But now that you understand that they had been watching, how you've been treating people. They had been watching how you've been loving on people. They had been watching on how you've been so faithful in your work and committed to that in which you were doing. Can you see that? So for that reason, this is where the Lord, for the person who has been watching, or for the people who has been watching you, yes, they said they want to see you. It's like, I'm sure a lot of you who are basically at work, when you're at work and all of a sudden the boss wants to see you and you're like, hey, is this for a promotion or is this for a review? So the same goes to those who have been in ministry at the same time. Maybe you've been waiting for an opportunity to show up, but yet, just like David, you've been in the field, you've been busy taking care of sheep and fighting the lion and fighting the bear, until all of a sudden Saul had to send a messenger to go and request for who? To go and request for David. Can you see that? So because at that moment in time, Saul was having a conversation, hey, you know, I need someone to play me some harp. Who can we get? And David was being suggested to Saul. So many of you, you know, the Lord has suggested you to the people who have been watching you from behind the scene, and now they want to have a meeting with you. Yes, they want to have a meeting with you. They want to have a sit down with you. They want to conversate with you. They want to basically talk to you. They want to see, you know, just that one-on-one chat with you, because they've been seeing everything that you've been doing. And majority of them, for what you've been doing, they are really pleased with the work of your hands. So for some of you, this is the promotion that you have been waiting for. You know, when the boss calls you, that's the first thing you're thinking about. Like, hey, is there a pay rise with this thing? You know, I'm just going to go in your faith. And for that reason, yes, you know, perhaps you go in, and then yeah, it's a promotion. But yes, so in the same line, for this in itself, for majority of you, indeed it is a promotion that is coming to majority of you in this hour, whether it's at your place of work or whether it's ministry. Yeah, because for what you have been doing, it is time for you, yes, to be recognized for your work. Because they came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee, with a request. They said they would like to see Jesus. Then Philip went to tell Andrew. Andrew and Philip in turn told Jesus. So now look at what Jesus said. He said, the hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. So for many of you, the meeting you're about to have is for the glory of the Lord to be revealed in everything that you've been doing. Yes, because you've been taking care of sheep in the wilderness. And now for many of you, it's time to come to the forefront to receive that in which the Father has prepared for you. I'm sure a lot of you who are much conversant with the Bible, you'll be much acquainted with Psalm 23 and 5. It says, I have prepared a table for you in the presence of your enemies. So this is what Jesus was speaking about. He said, the hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. He said, yep, the hour has come. Jesus had been doing the work. He had been doing everything to the point he rode into Jerusalem. Can you see that dimension where he told them, hey, if you don't praise me, hey, the rocks definitely over there, they will rise up to praise me. Can you see? And the Pharisees and the Sadducees, they were jealous in verse 19. They said, hey, look at it. You know, this is getting us nowhere. Look how the whole world has gone after him. So you can see, for what you've been doing, that's why they've come after you. Not after you in a bad way, after you because they would like to see you in order to receive what God has for you, to sit on the table that he has prepared for you. I trust many of you are basically ready for what the Lord is about to do through, in, with, and for you. It's about to be an amazing dimension, because majority of you, you have waited a long time for this, and now it is here. It's time to walk in it, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. I love you all so very much. You all are absolutely beautiful, and I thank God for you. And I want to congratulate you all in advance for that in itself, that as this basically comes to fruition, you know, the Lord will amaze him, you know, he will amaze you in so many dimensions to bring glory to his name through you in the environment in which he's leading you to. God bless you all. You all are beautiful, and I love you so, so very much. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.